So welcome back. This is kind of the next part about writing to a prison pen pal. What I wanted to kind of split this video up into is first talk about the general rules, and then in the second part talk about for gay men looking for pen pals and what that means. So in the general rules, you'll find a lot of websites that do that have pen pal listings for people who are in jails and prison. The most famous one is probably going to be writeaprisoner.com. They're the most organized. They have a lot of updated profiles all the time. I will say they tend to have a really poor way for you to find whether pen pals are located in a federal facility versus a local facility. There's no real way for you to separate between the two. You just have to look by state, I guess. So if you're looking, in general, some people like to look for a pen pal that who is not in the same state or are located further away from them, maybe on the other side of the country, as a safety issue, in case you're wondering if that person when they're released would come look for you. The other thing is that in terms of your mailing address, you can get a PO box that you can use as your address for them to mail things to you without disclosing your home address. Now, obviously a PO box is going to cost you extra money, but if you're willing to do that for your own privacy. And for some inmates, they also have access to email, and one of the primary services, like CoreLinks, which the federal prisons use. You register a CoreLinks account, and then basically it works like a regular email client, right? You then add inmates by their ID number, and then you approve that this is a person you want to talk to. When you send an email to them, it doesn't cost you anything to send them a message, but it does cost the inmate money to read it and potentially print out the email. Now, if you send something by email and you want them to reply by regular mail back to you, you actually have to write your regular mail address on the email, because otherwise there's no receipt that comes with that email that includes your mailing address. So that's one thing to remember. And also, if you're doing hard mail and sending it to prisons, a lot of the times the prisons and jails don't give the original envelope anymore. They just give whatever is the contents, and sometimes even that's a photocopy of the letter. So get into the practice of putting your name and mailing address on the letter, in addition to the person you're writing to, their name and their ID number on the letter, so that if the letter itself is separated from the like a packet, a stack of incoming mail, they know who it belongs to. They know it belongs to this inmate and it was sent by this person. All right, so the process of mailing in stuff to inmates is fairly easy, but remember that inmates are sending out letters because they have access to a stamp, whether they pay for it or they're indigent and they can ask their unit manager to get them a free stamp. But in general, if you're sending them three letters, and for them to use three stamps, that's costing a lot of money out of their own pocket. So I think for anybody who's interested in having a lot of frequent communication, is that you can send upwards of two letters before you expect a response, and you can tell them that I'm going to write you more frequently, but I would only expect you to reply back to me, say, once a month, versus I send letters to you twice a month. Because also for you as the pen pal, you may have a lot more stuff to talk about just because you're outside and you have all these things you can do. As an inmate, it would be nicer to hear kind of like what's changing on a like week-to-week basis, as opposed to asking the inmate to talk about what happens on a week-to-week basis, which may not change as much. If you watched my previous video, I did talk about somebody who had written for 2 years, and I used to write him on a weekly basis, actually, believe it or not, largely because he had, you know, a lot of problems adjusting to being in prison, because he had been in jail being detained for pretrial. But when he got into prison, he did not expect the sentence to be that long. He moved to the prison, which means that all the people he knew from jail were not with them, right? So it's all, for him, it's a lot of it is just starting all over. So I wrote to him weekly up to a certain point, and then I had to kind of trail off because I was handling my own case. But at this point, when I'm finishing off before I start my federal sentence, I've actually begun writing to him weekly again. And he's been writing me more frequently, knowing that, you know, the direct communication is going to end up, you know, disappearing at some point until we establish contact once I get to my facility. And then the last thing I want to talk about is, I do know, like, in terms of like pen pal ads, you may notice that there are a lot of guys looking for pen pals, but they say they only want female pen pals. And this is not because guys are homophobic, all right? And most of the time, those they will say that, you know, they don't say no gays, right? They say no guys. The reason being, and you have to remember that for guys in prison and jail, they are surrounded by other guys all the time. And yes, you can have gay and transgender inmates that may be perceived by other inmates as women, right? And they kind of serve that role of like this female energy for some inmates. But when you have an opportunity to actually communicate with a woman who's on the outside, that energy is being sent through those communications, those letters and all that, to the point some women like do things like they spray perfume on the letters, which is a big no-no. Don't do that. And men kind of, when they read these letters from these women, they get that female energy. And that's what they're looking for. They're not looking for a substitute kind of surrogate kind of female player kind of role. And so I know there are a lot of gay men who get really bent out of shape when they specifically say that it's women only, not looking for guys, and feeling like, well, how come you're like discounting guys when guys can be just as supportive? Well, no, because they already have gay guys in prison who can do this, who can talk to them and do all that, and you know, it's not a matter of whether or not they like or want to talk to a gay person. They specifically in this instance want to talk to a woman, and not always. And it also, the topics don't have to be about sex. We don't assume just because straight men want to talk to women means that they just want to have these kind of erotic kind of letters going back and forth, although it does happen. But it's not the general goal. The general goal is to have, you know, a woman who's writing to them, and then they kind of get that energy and they feel like, oh, all right, I'm feeling more of a whole of a person versus just this guy who's in prison with hundreds of other guys. So it's something that I know troubles, you know, gay men who are looking for pen pals, but you just gotta accept it. There are more than a good number of gay men who are in prison and in jail. I don't really understand why they're underrepresented in pen pal ads. Maybe because they don't need it, I guess. If they are feel like their lives inside prison doesn't require them to get pen pals. Occasionally I've seen some gay pen pal ads on websites like writeaprisoner.org, .com, but not often. So I don't really know what's up with that, but hey, when I get to federal prison and I ask some gay guys around why they don't do it, maybe I can give you the answer for that. So this is a, you know, I know it's a little bit long-winded, but just an explanation of, you know, the pen pal system, what you should do, what you should consider if you want to do it. And then, like I said, it's helped my buddy who's already done 2 years now, and he still has 10 more years to go. So, it helps. It really, really helps people to have a pen pal or a person who they can talk to on the phone or a video phone or email them. So if you've ever had any hesitation about doing it, here's my brand and seal of approval. All right. So I'll talk more about pen pals for you guys later. So catch up a future video on that coming out very soon. All righty. Bye.